lovely people who are in this group who are looking for answers, maybe from other facilitators who've already been certified. This is definitely the right place to be in. And it's so exciting because now we have our virtual live Zoom training. So it really goes over all those incredible elements of understanding what equine assisted learning is. And then of course we've got our major business day. Then of course we have our 3-day live hands-on training, and that would be globally. And again, when things open up, we know right now that things aren't the way they're supposed to be. But the other beautiful thing is in the virtual live training, you also get another, I don't know, like it's like an online course, except it's a whole bunch of tutorials. So we made all these tutorial videos just for you who cannot be with us in the hands-on right away. So at least you can practice all your programs. You can do all of your business. So it's not like you're having to wait to become certified to do this as a business. You get to do it as soon as you're trained. Plus you've got the online review training after the course. Plus you've got the world global support. And these are facilitators who help you globally. And there's so much more.
I was gonna say, and plus. But really it is, for us, it's about getting people to a place where they can work with their horses to help other people and doing whatever it takes to get them there as well. And like you were saying with the virtual, it's easy. You're starting now from your home.
Yes.
So you don't have to worry about the travel to get going, and you don't have to worry about all that piece until afterwards when COVID and is on its way out.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, that's the noise it makes me make.
It's so true. And I'm sure all of you must be already knowing us, but I feel weird that we didn't introduce ourselves. But hi, everyone. I'm Carrie.
And I'm Carolyn.
So one thing we wanted to talk about today is money, because you know, there's so many things that stop us from living, and money is one of them, because money is still a thing that we need in order to survive and live and pay for food to eat it so that we can live as humans. So we get that piece, but you know, sometimes we gotta take a look, we gotta change the way our thinking is as to what is an investment and what is a liability. And when we understand those pieces, this helps us to make decisions, whether this be the certification for us, whether starting a new business in another horse industry is for you, but it all still has to boil down to money. No matter what you do in this world, if you're starting something new that nobody else knows that is going to exist yet, it will always, always cost you money. Kind of like owning horses. It will always, always, always cost you money.
You know, sorry, I was going to say, they always say it takes money to make money. But you always have to make sure that you are putting that money into a place that's actually going to get you to make that money, right? It's not about, you know, an investment isn't throwing money at something and hoping it turns out. An investment is an investment in yourself and in something that's going to move you forward rather than just sitting where you are now and hoping things change.
And that's what's considered an asset. So when you know you're investing money into you, yourself, and I, that's the asset piece, because this asset, you need to know what your return on investment is going to be. And through that return on investment, you are the one that's going to move your business forward to what? Make money. That's why it's so exciting. Liabilities would be, this would never be a liability, for example, not when you put it into you, yourself, and I. A liability would be buying a boat, a motorcycle, well, heck, even our vehicle.
Yeah.
Even though we need it, we still, that money goes bye-bye. Yeah. You never get the money back, and those things cost money,
you
too.
You drive it off the lot,
yep,
and it goes,
yep,
way down.
That's exactly right. And, you know, I was just talking to my hubby the other day, and I said, you know, I wonder, because I invest in me all the time with personal development pieces, and you do too.
Yeah.
But I really do a lot of personal development, not just hearing what other people are doing, but I love to dance. So I spend a lot of money with personal coaches, with, in the olden days, group coaches. Now I actually do Zoom dance lessons as well. So I have not stopped, because I'm addicted to feeling that personal peace with inside me. So I was talking to my hubby about it, and we were like, holy Toledo's, in 1 year, only 1 year, I probably spent at least $5,000 just on me. And I am the asset, because why? I'm changing the way in my movement. So you see, I've invested in me, and it's showing through the money that I spend. But heck, if I travel to dance, that would even cost more money, but it's all so worth it. It's just like, well, anything that you love to do. And what we do for our kids all the time is we put them in things, right?
100%. And that adds up so much as well. And even for myself, doing a lot of that, I do a lot of the coaching or a lot of the leadership or anything else like that for Girl Guides, which doesn't cost me necessarily money, cost me time, but yeah. It cost me money to put my kid into everything, but I watch her grow through it, right? There's always something that we're investing in to have ourselves get to a different place, or something that even just makes us feel good as women, getting our hair done or our nails done. Sometimes that's the thing we need to feel pretty for that day or whatever it may be, right? But self-investment is huge. And this course is a self-investment as much as it is a business investment as well.
That is so true, because you're right. I love that you had said it that way, because not only do you get all of that for you, but the business training alone that you get, if you've never been in business before, or you even have another business and you're doing this as an additional self-employed business, like, it's phenomenal, the freedom that you have to be your own boss, but you get to work with horses all the time. You get to see before your very eyes a human make a change. Why? Not because you said the words, because the horse actually did the communication with that human. So the human was empowered to say, I think I gotta really believe that I can move forward. And then the horse moves. Like, it's just so powerful. And if you already have horses, you see, here's the thing. They are and would be that liability piece to especially our spouses or our partners, but they're not when they're part of your business, because now they get put into those write-offs with the government. If you already have a job, it's so beautiful because you're already getting income tax taken off. And then you have these beautiful components of what? All of the money that it costs to have a horse. The farrier, the deworming, the hay, the shoes, the but even your house, your cell phone, your everything now get to be a part of this business that you're creating. So you see, this is really investing and what's going to be more in the future, which is a return on investment, so you make money. So every rich person on this earth has invested to make money.
So true.
They don't bury their money. They don't hold their money just in case they need it. They actually spend the money in investing so that they make more money. And that's what the course is all about. Yep. It really is making more money.
I love Lisa. You can tell we've got a true fan here.
Oh, too. Lisa.
So Lisa's on. She says, doing the online training, I've already learned better ways to help me homeschool my son better.
Oh, I love that.
And that's even without the main course. So you're right. There's so much. Oh, value. Parenting. Holy Toledo. It's
changes.
That I love your world. She threw in tuna fish.
She did. She knows the holy jump in tuna fish. I love that a lot.
If the rest of you don't know what we're talking about, go watch your other lives.
Absolutely. So think about this, if you will. What is one thing? And maybe you are frugal. Who knows? I mean, Carolyn always says she's very frugal,
but not cheap.
And that's right. And there is a difference, because you got to be smart with your money, especially if it's in a time that you don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
We get all that. However, think about something that you would spend on yourself on a regular basis, even if it's a Starbucks coffee, even if it's going, I don't know, out for supper even once a week. How much does that really cost you on a regular basis? Like my dance. If I only dance once a week, it still costs me at least $5,000 for the year to do that.
Yep.
So you see, even investing to a business, a certification, it's actually pretty cheap to start a business, because there's not too many businesses. If you had to go get a degree in how do you manage and run and market a business and all the time, and you're with us forever and ever, amen. Unless you want to divorce us, but I don't know.
I don't think you do.
I don't think you do either.
With that frugal piece too, I know a lot of you are probably in the same position as I would be, is it's looking at that as a risk. And that's cool. Look at things in life. There are risks, 100%. But it's, again, posing it against the reward. You have to really look. Yes, there's always a risk when you put out money, when you buy a new car, when you take a course, when you buy a new horse. Shirt, get a new horse. There's always a risk in that piece that maybe something won't work, or that maybe the car is going to be a lemon, or maybe the shirt's not going to fit. You can't return it. All of these things have risk, but what's the reward? What's the benefit out of taking that risk? And if that far outweighs the risk itself, that's where you're making an investment with your money, rather than, you know, maybe being a little, I don't know what the word is. Infrugal is not a word.
I don't think so, but you can make it up.
What's the word, people?
Anyways.
Loosey-goosey with money.
Okay, loosey-goosey with money. We hope that this has helped in any which way. Because remember, you are the gift. You are the talent. You are the asset. You're getting trained for yourself to be able to help other humans to be able to make changes for themselves. But the bonus is always with the horse. To breathe in every day that beautiful smell of a horse and to literally make a living doing it. There is nothing like it in the world. I couldn't have even dreamt that it would be this life-changing or this solid or this purposeful ever until you start doing it. Like, it's that amazing. And we're always here for you, too. If you want to call us to chat, please do, or email us. But, you know, sometimes on the phone helps you, too, because then you got your pros and your con list going. Yep. And then you can get all of the questions answered that maybe you're sitting on the fence about.
And we're cool with questions.
See, we love questions.
Yeah, I've actually had one person call and they were like, I feel bad asking these questions. I'm like, why? Wouldn't you want to figure out that we're not nuts? Like, again, this is my frugal self. But if I'm spending that much money, I'm going to want to know that I'm not signing up with some crazy people who don't actually know what they're doing. Yeah, call us, talk to us, ask us the questions, the straight up questions. We are so cool with that.
Absolutely. So make it happen. Make it your day. You are always worth it. You are worth every single thing that you put into you.